Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen, wa salatu wa salam ala Rasulillahi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. My dear brothers and sisters in faith, assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuhu. Inshallah ta'ala, I will be sharing with you one of the messages of the Muhammad of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, which is the hadith that Abu Hurairah radiallahu ta'ala anhu narrated. Qala, anna Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam qala, ينزل الله إلى السماء الدنيا كل ليلة حين يبقى ثلث الليل الآخر فيقول أنا الملك من ذا الذي يدعوني فأستجيب له من ذا الذي يسألني فأعطيه من ذا الذي يستغفرني فأغفر له فلا يزال كذلك حتى يضيء الفجر حديث reported by Imam Bukhari, Imam Muslim وغيرهما من أهل الحديث and all the narrators of the hadith, they reported the hadith to the point that Imam Ibn Qayyim rahimahullah ta'ala said the hadith was reported over by 29 companions of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Hadith mutawatir, hadith reported by sahaba, that there are more than 29 sahaba in the book of hadith. Now, what is the meaning of this hadith? This hadith goes like this, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala descends every night when it is the last third of the night. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in His majesty, He descends from the heaven. He descends that befitting Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the superior, the blessed. He says, I am the sovereign, I am the king. Is there anyone who calls upon me so that I may respond to him? Is there anyone who asks of me that I may give him? Is there anyone who seeks forgiveness from me so that I may forgive him? He continues in that until the illumination of the Fajr, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Allah is so merciful. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He descends from the heaven to the last heaven every night, which is almost like an hour before Salat al-Fajr, or more than that. That is the moment Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala descend to listen to His servant. Allah is not going to send anybody, He will descend by Himself. Allah wants to listen to you. He said three things. Number one, who is the person? Who is the person that wants me to respond to his need? I'm there to respond for him, to his need. Who is the person? Number two, the Prophet sallallahu said, Allah also is going to ask, who is the person that wants my forgiveness? We shall forgive him. Who is the person that is seeking for my mercy? Who is the person that needs me? I'm there to help him. This is opportunity for you and I. This is opportunity for you to wake up before Fajr to call upon your God. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is coming, is descending to listen to you. Complain your matter to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Don't go to anybody. Allah is there to listen to you. Definitely Allah will answer your dua. If you have hope in Him, definitely Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will answer your prayer. My dear brothers and sisters in Islam, use this golden opportunity to call upon your Creator, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Shaitan, Al-La'in, He will never want you to be able to wake up, and you will realize that is the moment that you enjoy your sleep most. The moment an hour before Fajr, that is the moment you enjoy your sleep. That is the moment that Shaitan doesn't want you to stand up and consult your Allah, your Creator. But if you can split to the light and say, Auzubillahi minash shaitani rajim, try as much as possible and wake up and fight shaitan. Then you can contact your Lord, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah said, He's there to answer your need. Anything you need from your Lord, talk to Him directly. Allah said, He's closer than you than any other thing. He has the knowledge of everything that you are doing. The knowledge of everything that you are doing is with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So Allah will answer your call, my dear brothers and sisters in Islam. But before you will be able to receive the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and His blessing upon you, four things that you must consider. Says by Imam Ibn Qayyim rahimahullah ta'ala, and he says, you must fulfill these following conditions. Number one, having certainty. Have certainty that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will surely answer your dua. You're not praying or you're not calling Allah, then you are having doubtfulness in calling Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Maybe Allah will answer your dua or He will not answer it. That is against the teaching of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Number two, submissiveness and devotion. When you are calling upon your Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala during your dua, call Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with devotion. Don't call Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with an upset heart. Draw your attention to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Definitely Allah will answer your dua. Number three, be patient and do not hasten for an answer. Don't say, okay, if I call upon my Lord today, I will see the result. I will see answer to my dua tomorrow. Be patient. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will answer your dua. Lastly, continue to gain a lawful means of living. I know it is difficult. Maybe your means of living, it is full of haram. It is full of impermissible stuff. But little gradually, try and reduce it. If it is not possible for you to get rid of everything once, but try as much as possible. Allah will make it easy for you. This is my message for you. Try as much as possible. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala definitely will answer your dua. He answer our dua. In terms of ni edigu kuru, ona ni pe, anabi sallallahu alaihi wasallam. O so ninu oro re, oro pe ni agbara ni. O so pe kini, oni Olorun ba like ola, pelu Olorun re, pelu bo di tobi to ni. O ma so kale fun ara re lati oke sanmo. Mejeje wa si oke to pari sile aye, wa si sanmo yi to gbe sile aye patapata. Ki Olorun bo wa se, ko ba se nkankan to koja pe kini, o wa dahun ibere mi ati eyin na ni. Ki na ni pe kini in to ba n bere lowo Olorun ba like ola ti o ti de lo lati joy omo lo ba n bere ni aya lo ba n bere ni o fe travel out ni o fe sorire ni o fe ifokan ba le gbe si aye re o fe imo to ye koro Olorun ba like ola nbo o nbo wa down si bere re anything to ba n bere lowo Olorun ba like ola take opportunity particularly ninu osu Ramadan ta wa osu owo osu aponle bi Olorun ba like ola re ma sa lo anybody Olorun ba like ola o nbe nbe lati de lo gbogbo le yo rorun fun Olorun ba like ola lati se amo kile to le se o gburo fokan bale o gburo moju to condition merin kile on condition na ala kokoro o na ni pe kini bi yan ba n pe Olorun ba like ola ke yan ni amodaju ipa pe kini adu awon o gba e yan pe Olorun pelu maybe okan meji e amo boya Olorun ma gba amo boya ko ni gba na ara ni amodaju pe adura mi o lati gba ni inshallah adura re o si gba elekeji o na ni pe kini devotion ke yan pa gbogbo kan yan po sodo Olorun ba like ola eyan ki ma pe Olorun ba like ola kokan yo titu wa ni bi se ebe kokan yo ti wa ni bomi eleyi o ba ilana ike pe Olorun ba like ola eleketa nbe ke yan se suru eyan ki kanju Olorun ba like ola o mo boye toto re ko ti kan e pe wa kan Olorun ba like ola yo sa mi soro re se suru gbogun to n gbere Olorun ba like ola ti o ti kan e lowo o n para bo wa to e lowo inshallah eleke ni nbe o na ni pe kini gbiyanju ko ri pe ona je re ona mu re o je ona halal o je ona eto gbiyanju ko se le to ba ti moju tele pelu ogun Olorun pelu ogun Olorun Olorun ba like Olorun ba sa mi si oro re gbogbo n ta be lowo Olorun ba like Olorun ma sa sa mi si gbogbo to ti wa to wa lo Olorun ma gba ku lowo ikokun ori ta be lowo Olorun Olorun ma sa se be ikokun subhanaka allahumma bihamdik ashhadu an la ilaha illa anta astaghfiruka wa atubu ilayk.